Engineers at Northwestern University have developed a flying microchip. It's about the size of a grain of sand and does not actually have a motor or engine. It flies around by being dispersed by the wind. Here now to tell us more about it is Northwestern professor and bioelectronics pioneer John Rogers. Good morning.
Hello. Hey, thanks for having me.
I'm sure you anticipate that this makes people nervous that it's going to be easier for people to spy on other countries, spy on us. To those people, what do you say?
Well, that's not kind of the emphasis or the motivation behind our technology development efforts. I suppose, you know, any new technology could be used for nefarious purposes, and that's kind of a risk that you have to, you know, accommodate and consider when you're developing a new form of engineering technology. So we appreciate the concern. It's not what we're thinking about. But, you know, it's probably within the realm of future possibility, you know, if you think about the range of applications.
So what is the design intention with this? What are you saying these are the great things this can do?
Well, environmental monitoring is kind of our focus. We've historically been interested in sensors to monitor personal health, and adapting those sensors for monitoring the health of our surroundings seemed like a natural extension for us. And these tiny wings allow for, you know, efficient rapid dispersal of tiny sensors that can monitor environmental processes. You could track airborne pathogens, for example, heavy metal exposure in the environment, things of that sort. And we think those kinds of data streams could be very important as we sort of manage disease spread and we, you know, remediate a chemical spill, for example. These sorts of sensors could be very useful in those contexts. And that's kind of our emphasis, what we're hoping to achieve.
And is there some concern for what happens to these things? Are they just kind of end up like littering the environment? What if animals eat them? Do they just sort of disintegrate quickly? How does it work?
Yeah, that's a very important question. I think if we didn't have an answer to that question, we probably wouldn't have even started down this research path. We've been interested in temporary biomedical implants, electronics go inside the body and function for some period of time and then ultimately dissolve away and disappear, very much like a resorbable suture. So we have all of the technology for building then environmentally degradable forms of electronics, and that's the strategy. You disperse these devices into the environment, they operate over a stable period of interest, but then ultimately just disappear, you know, and degrade and in a benign way that eliminates that waste stream, that eliminates the pollution, and we have all the capabilities for doing that.
So is this like still in the Kickstarter phase, or are we going to see these like tomorrow?
It's early phases of research, I would say. You know, we just published our first peer-reviewed paper on this technology, and so we're just getting started. I run an academic group here at Northwestern, so it's exploratory engineering science is kind of what we're doing. But we're pretty excited about this direction. We've received a lot of inbound interest from industry groups, other academic research groups, thinking to build on these concepts, and we think that that's great, and that they could be used for societal benefit. That's the ultimate goal here.
It's fascinating. For more information, you can check out rogersgroup.northwestern.edu. John Rogers, thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you.